In this session, we will discuss Gauss elimination with partial pivoting. So far, we have been doing a solution for the system of linear equations by converting into triangular form, or we were doing Gauss elimination and back substitution. We saw, like for an example, I'm saying, we saw that in the triangular form, we had something like 2, 3, 1. Let's say it was A. I'm leaving it so that we can have a feasible solution here. 6, 5, B, and maybe 7. D. So let's say this is A augmented B, which we formed using the elementary transformations. Obviously, these elements are 0. So, in this triangular form, these diagonal elements A11, A22, A33 are the elements below which, for that particular column, like for column 1, the diagonal element is 2, A11 is equal to 2, and the below elements are 0. For column 2, we have A22 as 6, and the elements below this as 0. Likewise, we don't have the elements, otherwise we would have those elements to be also 0 if we had column 4 like that. So these elements are going to be the pivot. These elements are going to be the pivot here, right? So the point is, if we have a certain equations given, we'll try to make that for every column, like we start with the first column and we check like among such and such values, which is having the largest absolute value, and we'll try to fix it for the diagonal element of that column. Then we'll fix that row, and after that we'll move to the second column and we'll check the rest of the rows, like we have already fixed row 1. So we'll check for the other two rows and we'll see which is the largest, having the largest absolute value in column 2. And then as per the, like if the row 3 is having the largest element, we'll switch it with row 2 and we'll make this A22 being the largest element of this column 2 after considering that row 1 is already fixed. Likewise, then row 2 will be also fixed. Then we'll move to column 3 and then compare it for the other elements, and likewise we'll do keep on doing it, right? So why is it done? Like for a normal matrix with close to values like 2, 3, 4, 5 and all, it is fine. If you don't do this partial pivoting, that is also fine. We'll get the right solution only. But if the elements are going to be very small or very large in comparison to each other, in that case, if we don't use partial pivoting, we can expect error in the solution, because while we'll be trying to form a triangular form of these equations, the elementary transformation which we will be using, in that case we'll get the round off errors, and this round off errors will make the final solution to be far from the original, or you can say that there will be certain errors. So we can say partial pivoting is used to reduce a round of error, and interchanging of a row, majorly row or column, is done in order to use the largest largest in sense largest absolute value. So I'll say largest as pivot or as pivot element, right? So let's see how we are going to do this. Let's say we have an example. Solve you can clearly see that the difference between the numbers are very large, like 1 and 0.02. This is like almost 50 times greater than this. And likewise, 0.02 and 800, this is also very multiple time of 0.02. So these values are having large difference. And in that case, we'll have to do partial pivoting so that we'll have to avoid the round off error, and then we can get the approximate answer, right? So let's start with column 1. In this column 1, we'll see that out of all these 4 elements, these 2 are already 0, and out of 0.02 and 1, the absolute value of 1 is higher than 0.02, right? So what we can do is we can exchange row 2 with row 1. So we'll get 1 2 1 0 1, then this will become 0.02 0.01 0 0 0.02 0 1 2 1 4. Right, so now this row 1 has this element for as a pivot for column 1. We can see for column 1, this is the absolute value having the largest one. So now what we'll do, we'll fix this row 1. We don't have to do anything about with this, we'll be like this only for the next steps. Now step 2, or you can say in the same step also, it is possible, like we can see for column 1 to make it in triangular form, for column 1 we have to make this element to be 0 now. In column 1 this is the pivot and the elements below this has to be 0. So we can do some elementary operations and we can say see how to make it 0. So in that case, the operation which we can do is, row 2 can be changed at row 2 minus 0.02 times of row 1. You see, if we do row 2 minus 0.02 times of row 1, this element will become 0, right? So what we'll get is 1 2 1 0 1, this will become 0. right? This row 1 is fixed. Now we'll see for column 2. We'll go for column 2. Column 1, we already have the pivot. Pivot is 1 here. The elements below it are now 0. So in this column 2, we have -0.03 and 1 and then 0. This has to be fixed, so we won't see this 2. We'll see the elements on the diagonal elements and below this. This is already fixed, so we cannot do anything about it. Now, among these two, this is having the higher value. Absolute value is higher. So the steps which we can do is, we can, like I'm writing here, step 2. We can do is, we can exchange row 3 and row 2. So this comes out here. And then further, what we can do is, we can do operations. Let's write what we will get now. It will be 1. This is what we'll have. And now for column 2, now this is the pivot and the elements below this has to be made 0. So what operation we can do is, the operation can be row 3 plus 0.03 times of row 2. 0.03 times of row 2 will make this element to be 0. So let's say we are doing this operation and we'll get this is what we'll get. So this is the pivot, elements below this are 0. This is the pivot, below elements are 0. For column 3, we'll see these two row, like row 2 will be fixed now. Row 2 is fixed. So row 2 is fixed, and then we're moving to column 3. We'll check row 3 and row 4. And after this, row 3 and row 4, you can see that row 4 is having the higher absolute value than row 3. So step 3 is going to be, exchange of row 3 and row 4. So we'll get so these are the elements, right? Now for this 0 or 100, column 3, the element below this diagonal element 0.04 has to be made 0. So what we can do is, we can do an elementary operation. Row 4 minus, we can see this is already 100 times than 0.04, so we'll have to do minus 0.004. 0.04 times of R3, right? 0.04 and then 100. So that becomes 0.0004 times of R3. And that will make the this. And from here we can use back substitution. So back substituting will get, first of all we'll get x4. X4 will become minus 0.045 times of x4 will be minus 0.2. So you can say 4 times of this is giving this. So x4 becomes 4. So coming back to this, 4 times of this will be 800. So 800 gets cancelled. 100 times of x3 equal to 0. So x3 becomes 0. Again, this is 0. This is 4. So 4 and 4 cancel. So x2 also becomes 0. x1. These and these are 0. This is 0 into 4 will also be 0. So x1 becomes 1. So this gives the solution.